Across the Metroplex, lines to get a COVID test extremely long, with some wait times as long as 5 hours. But do you actually really need a test? And what do you do if that test is positive? Our Andrea Lucia set out to get some answers.
And then I woke up on Sunday, and I literally just felt like a truck had hit me. Whole body was aching, headache, sore throat.
Despite getting fully vaccinated and boosted, Matthew Kinzer says he's tested positive for COVID.
I don't think it hit me probably as hard as it could have had I not had all vaccine shots. So I'm glad I did get that.
But like, did you really want to know one way or the other if you had this?
Yes, I did. I wanted to make sure, A, that what we did was correct.
But knowing what to do isn't always easy. Getting a COVID test can mean waiting in line for hours. Effective monoclonal antibody treatments are now in short supply. And CDC guidelines keep changing.
A lot of people are getting sick. A lot of people are confused what to do.
Dr. David Winter with Baylor Scott & White says you probably don't need a test because whether it's COVID or the flu, the treatment is the same.
So if you're vaccinated, you have a healthy immune system, and your symptoms are minimal, just stay home, drink lots of water, get plenty of bed rest, and monitor your symptoms.
You may need to go to a hospital, though, if you have increased weakness, confusion, or worsening shortness of breath.
One way you can actually help to monitor that is these oxygen sensors. You can get one of these at the pharmacy. They don't cost that much, and you can use these to test and see if your oxygen level is going down. If your oxygen level goes down below 92, you need to contact somebody.
If after 5 days you have no symptoms, the CDC says you can now end your quarantine as long as you stay masked around others. If you still have a fever or other symptoms, stay home until they clear up.
I'm just catching up on Netflix shows.
In Dallas, Andrea Lucia, CBS 11 News.